Hi everyone, welcome to Vigik channel. So in this video I'll show you how you can take really gorgeous images on this Huawei Honor 9 Lite. And this Honor 9 Lite, although the budget phone they have provided several pro level options that you can use for to get really good images. So that is what I am going to show you. This will also apply to a lot of other smartphones. You can take really good images on that smartphone as well. So let's straight away jump into the video. And I've got a really beautiful scenery here, as you can see. We shall also move to other places, but the main objective of this video is that how you can take really good images with several tweakings in the settings. So that is what I'm going to show you. Let's start with the video. So in order to move to the camera, go to the camera, you just have to swipe over and you'll be greeted with the camera's viewfinder. This is the camera viewfinder for the Huawei Honor 9 Lite. As you can see, right now this is a golden, or you can say sort of in the sunrise time period. So as you can see that the auto white balance is not properly corrected here. So just swipe from the left and you'll get this pro photo mode. You just tap on that and here you see various different settings that you can tweak for. So how you can change however you want the style, the way. This is the electro level meter that you can see here. I have enabled it while going in the settings here. You can use this assistive grid. You can tap on the horizontal level so that you get this electronic level meter. Now once you have this, you can horizontally align and see which way the composition is perfect. So to change the auto white balance, there is this option over here. You just tap on that. Currently this is set to custom auto white balance. Here you can see, if you just scroll over, you can see that there is auto white balance, there is a shade. As I click on this, as I tap on this, you can see how the viewfinder really live shows me what type of image I'm getting. So here you can see now I have changed to daylight tungsten, and this is a shade, this is a sunny, and there is also custom white balance, which is really good feature. Now if I just slide over here, you can really adjust the perfect color and take the image. So just tap on focus. You tap on focus where you want to focus. Typically on landscape images like this, you want to focus a little bit on the downside so that you get really sharp images across the board. So just tap on this and there you have this beautiful image. So this way you can correct the auto white balance. The next feature we are going to look out is this AFC, which is autofocus continuous. There is also autofocus single. One time if you tap, it will be focused on that particular area. If you want to continuously focus, so you can keep this AFC. The next function is this setting called exposure value. This is really good. Say that now if I hold the camera like this, the viewfinder, you can see there is a lot of dark, the image is not properly lit. In order to bring this, compensate the exposure, you can just tap on this and increase the auto exposure value. As you can see now how the scenery is getting evenly lit, and you can just tap on the picture and get this image. Before this, if I had capture, there is a little bit of darkness here. This is how you compensate the exposure value. The next setting I'm going to show you is the shutter speed. Say that there are quite a lot of fast moving objects in the scenario, or say there is a stream of water. What you can do is to set the shutter speed value to the scenario what you want to capture. So based on that, if you select the shutter speed, faster the shutter speed, the higher the value, that is 1/1250th, you go more the value, then you get a fast shutter speed. Otherwise the shutter speed will be low and you need to have very stable and steady hands to get the right picture. So the next setting is the ISO. Now it is set to auto. You can change the ISO. Lower the ISO number, the smoother the images you get, the lesser the noise images will be. And if you increase the ISO number, you'll get a lot of noise in the images. So I think it is better to leave at the auto level itself so that the camera decides for itself. The another most important thing I would like to show is, we'll just move to another location and show you what the metering function does. So another important thing that I would like to showcase is how the metering work modes and why it is really important to meter the images properly. So here's the metering method. This is the center weight metering right now we are in, and there is the matrix metering as well as spot metering. All these settings are available on DSLR cameras, so it is really great to see Honor has provided on such a budget level phone. So here you can see that center weight metering means that most of the sensor inside the camera will concentrate, focus on the center weight things so that you get properly exposed images over here and the rest will be neglected. So that way, if you want everything in focus, especially for the landscape photography, you want to select this matrix metering and capture the picture. So this is how you get the proper in focus pictures. The other way is to actually select the center metering when there are some particular persons, or if you are capturing say some proper only single or two subjects inside the picture, inside the frame. So if you want to do that, you have to select the center weight metering, and this is how you get the image. And the important thing is that whenever you want to get that background blur, extra blur you want, and you want to capture flowers in a beautiful way, there is this spot metering. This is what you want to keep spot metering and capture really close-up objects, such as I'll show you the difference between these metering. As you can see, there is a pole over here. So if I tap on this and make focus of this and capture the image, see, the Honor 9 Lite is really hunting for the focus. So if I just capture the image, as you can see that there is a lot blur in the background and there is a lot focus on this particular image. If you capture the same image using the center weight or other metering, it won't be like that. This is the matrix metering, and I'll just tap the focus on this pole again, and if I capture the picture, as you can see, still the background is very much in focus along with this pole. So this is how you how the metering works. So after all, I have shown this, all these are the professional settings, and I hope this little tutorial was helpful for you guys. If yes, please like the video, hit that subscribe button, and stay tuned. I'll be doing more videos. If you have any questions, don't hesitate to leave them in the comment section below. I'll be explaining more of this. I hope this little video was helpful. See you all in the next one. Take care. Bye bye.